On May 19, 1930, Lorraine was born to the family of Carl and Nannie Hansberry. She was the youngest of four children. She was born during the Depression in a middle-class family. Together, her family was involved in activism and civil rights and formed a foundation to assist people in their community. Her father was a member of the NAACP, Urban League, and also ran for Congress. Her mother was active in the community and served as a ward committee woman. Her uncle was a prominent historian that taught at Howard University. At the age of 5 years old, Lorraine received beatings from her classmates because she wore a white fur coat to school that she had been given for Christmas. The beatings took place because it showed a sign of wealth during the Depression, heightened by race. By the age of 8, her father decided to move the family to a white suburb, which led the family to eviction based on race discrimination. In 1940, the Hansberry family challenged this case and took it to the Supreme Court, and won. However, the public still disapproved, and mobs would gather around their home. The furious mob would throw objects through the window, and one time came very close to hitting Lorraine in the head with a brick. Her father, Carl, then planned a trip to Mexico in search of a home for his family to escape the racism in the United States. However, he was unsuccessful and suffered a brain aneurysm, which led to death. Lorraine began to become involved throughout high school and served as president of the debating team, and became involved in peace and freedom movements. After high school, she attended the University of Wisconsin of Madison and Roosevelt University. School wasn't much of her interest, so in 1950, she moved to New York to work for a close family friend, Paul Roberson. She started out as a secretary and soon was promoted to writing and editing articles. She became the associate editor of Freedom and worked for W.E.B. Du Bois. As a year passed, she represented Paul Roberson at the International Peace Foundation. In 1952, Lorraine met Robert Nemiroff while they were both protesting segregated sports teams at New York University. Robert was a Jewish publisher, songwriter, and activist. They were married the next year. Lorraine quit her full-time job and began her career as a writer.
Her most famous book is The Crystal Star, which was later named A Raisin in the Sun. It came from a line in a Langston Hughes poem. Some of her other works included On Summer, The Drinking Gourd, What Use Are Flowers, The Movement, Documentary of a Struggle for Equality, The Sign in Sidney Brustein's Window, and To Be Young, Gifted, and Black, Lorraine Hansberry in Her Own Words. A Raisin in the Sun opened at Ethel Barrymore Theater on Broadway and ran 530 performances.
Well, that's nice. You must come again, Mr.
Asagai. Asagai.
Yes, well, do come again.
Call me.
Ah, that sure was a pretty thing that just walked out of here. I see how come we done become so interested around here in Africa all of a sudden. Missionaries, Ma Jenny.
Oh, Mama.
In 1962, Lorraine and Robert were divorced, though they continued to work together. A Raisin in the Sun was the first play produced on Broadway by an African-American woman. Lorraine received an award at the Cannes Film Festival for this book. Hansberry was the first black playwright and the youngest American to win a New York Critics Circle Award. In 1964, the same year The Sign in Sidney Brustein's Window opened, Hansberry was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. She died on January 12, 1965. After her death, her ex-husband, Nemiroff, adapted a collection of her writing and interviews in To Be Young and Gifted and Black, which opened off Broadway at the Cherry Lane Theater, and it ran for 8 months. Lorraine began to write this while she was working with W.E.B. Du Bois. It was the first play written by an African-American woman to be produced on Broadway.
When Nina Simone wrote the song,
to be young, gifted, and black, she wrote it about Lorraine Hansberry.
Ooh, 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 and I'm feeling good.
She was her friend. She said Lorraine Hansberry made her realize she was a black woman living in a white man's world.
River running free.
The church pastor read a letter wrote by Martin Luther King, who was unable to attend Hansberry's funeral. Although Martin Luther King Jr. was unable to attend, respectable figures like Malcolm X were able to attend. More recently, you might have seen Lorraine Hansberry's work and not even realized it. The ABC television network aired A Raisin in the Sun in 2008, starring people like Sean Combs, Felicia Rashad, Audra McDonald, Sana Lathan, and even John Stamos.
My mom wants so many things. My mom wants so many things. It's kind of driving me crazy.
What happens to a dream deferred?
I got a boy who sleeps in the living room. I got to share a bathroom with two floors of people.
Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun?
He needs something. Something I can't give him.
Maybe it just sags like a heavy load.
I'm tired, ain't you, babe? Tired of everything. Me, the boy, the way we live.
Or does it explode?
Money is life.
Money is life? I remember a time when freedom used to be life.
Today, there is a theater named after Lorraine Hansberry. It was founded in 1981 by the late Stanley E. Williams, a founding artistic director, and the late Quentin Easter, founding executive director. LHT performed 7 seasons in numerous venues around San Francisco.
Never blow, and ain't gonna be treated this away.